So today I am telling you about the QBasic app. The first part I told you, I already shown you how to download it. Okay, now I am telling you about how to open and how to use the interface of QBasic 64 in our mobile phone. So click on the play and just loading. This part is over in the part 1, but still now I am telling you again. Now after opening of this, the few interfaces are looking like in this way. There's some images are there. So simply click on here, enter. Now this is the interface, but if you want to click on the file directly, it is not working. So what you have to do, simply click on the function key of orange key, and this arrow mark is showing the letters enable and disables. If those are letter disables, if you want to enable, so click on the arrow mark. That means disable color in the background brown color and the enable color is black. Now see the function key, you click here, so function key, when you are clicking, so F10 above mouse is present is there, click on the mouse. So your touch screen is enabled, and if you want to click, so click button is also given over there, so click on the click. So in this way you have to do the practical in your mobile phone. And orange keyboard is showing there. When you are clicking on the orange keyboard, so keypad is activated. Now see how to type the program and how to use the keyboard of this software. If you want to use opening bracket or closing bracket, C, whenever I want to change the symbols, so I'm clicking on the arrow mark of ABC orange color above the function button above. So that key you have to use. If you want to insert dollar sign, so click on that arrow mark. If you want to insert 3, so you can click on the arrow, then 3 will, the number will be activated and the symbol will be disabled in the brown color form. Right now 1, 2, 3 in the disabled form. When you again clicking on the ABC arrow mark, so your 3, 4 will be activated, and see the 1, 2, 3 activated and the other symbol is deactivated. So deactivated color was showing in the brown color. So in this way you have to do it. And some red color arrow mark was showing here. The left, up, down and right is for to moving your cursor on your programming. Spacebar is given and run command is also given in your keyboard, and the cross sign is showing you if you want to remove any character from your interface. And if you want to go down, so click on the enter as same as your keyboard. And if you want to run this program, so you have to use the shortcut key of F6. Otherwise you can click on the function key, and above the F10 function key showing the mouse, click on the mouse, and through a cursor you can click on the run command and click on the start. So always remember that the F5 is the shortcut key to run your program. Okay, this is the same interface though we are doing the practical in our computer lab by using the QBasic 64. That is the same interface you are using in your mobile phone. Okay, and this software is not available in the Play Store. Just I already shown in the part 1 video how to download QBasic 64, so you can check it my video over there. So this is the my channel, the CP Tech Bo, and I am Prashant Chobe, the your YouTubers, the telling this educational video to the students. Those don't want to purchase the computer, or you can say they not having a that much of amount to purchase the computer, so that's why I'm providing this platform to do the practical at home only. So in this way you have to make the practical, and this is the QBasic program. It is a quick all purpose. Okay, QBasic, quick beginner all purpose symbolic instruction code. It is a full form of QBasic. Okay, and it is the basic programming language. Before you are moving on the higher level language, you need to be learned first this this programming language, because it is related to our C and C++. Okay, and when you learn the coding now, so you will be very happy to make the programming, any kind of programming, just like the mathematical functions of programming. And if you want to create the business application, so that would is also possible to make the programming by using this QBasic. See how to save your file. So whenever you are giving your name, don't use the space because it's showing the error. After giving the name, full stop at the dot, then give the extension BAS. It is the extension of QBasic. After typing the name, activate your mouse and click on the OK. Take your cursor to OK and press the click button. Now S. Okay. See here, the space given is there. That's why it's prompt the error. So I'm removing the space and giving the short name. And .bas is the extension. If you are not giving a .bas, so your program will not save properly. So be careful while typing the program name and don't forget to mention the .bas. See, again is showing the error. Why? Because the program name is too lengthy. So please make it short. See now, take your cursor to OK and click on the button. Yeah, now your program is saved. Now look here, your name was showing here in the program before is untitled. Now it's showing the F1st and this is the running program. Press the F5, other click on the run, first number enter, second number enter, and now showing the total. That means I shown here the program addition of two number. In this way you have to make the remaining other program. So just one example I show you here. This is the manual way how to run your program. Take your cursor to the run and press the click button. See, same thing. Either you have to go to the click on the run, either you have to press the F5. F5 is the shortcut key to run your program. So output is always showing in the black color of its screen. It is easy to see. Now if you want to go back, click continue to enter. So in this I already told you the variable A and B is having, so whatever the user was entering the number, so that number is as a reading by the program as a variable A and B. So in this way you have to make the different types of program and run it and make it and enjoy the fun of your educations and enjoy your practical at your mobile phone. No need to attend the lab. Okay, so big lab having and computer is taking more time to take. So for that students having only those having some difficulty how to do the practical, so many students ask me, so how to do the practical in mobile phone because we are not attending the practical at school or due to some this circumstances going on the COVID-19. Now see here how to open your file. Click on the file, click on the OK, then select your file and click on OK. Simple is that. See the sample program I open here. Again, see how to open your program. Open, click on file, open, select your file name, then program name, then OK. See, this is the program. In this way I have to do. Thank you.